Okay, in this lecture, I'm just going to a little bit explain the degree of freedom. So, basically, we have already used degree of freedom. Normally, we denote with the sign of DF. So, basically, we use this degree of freedom in the student t distribution and the ANOVA and in the chi-square statistic. So, first of all, you need to know the concept, the definition of degree of freedom. So, what is degree of freedom? The number of degrees of freedom is the number of value in the final calculation of a statistic that are free to vary. So, mean you can also understand this meaning from the degrees of freedom. That means how much you can move in a circle in a specific zone freely. So, I will discuss this definition with a simple example. Suppose, for example, you have 7 different pen. So, you can see these are 7 pen and you have 7 lectures in each day. Now, you want to use a specific pen, a specific color for each and every lecture. So, for example, if you use a blue color pen for first lecture, so you will not use it for other lectures. If you use a yellow pen for second lecture or for first lecture or for third, you will not be able to use it for a second lecture. So, now you will understand this concept that for first lecture, how many choices you have? Because at the moment you have 7 pen. So, for first lecture, you can choose blue, you can choose yellow, you can choose red, you can choose pink, you can choose green, blue and gray. So, you have 7 choices. So, you can freely choose 7 pen among these 7 collection. The total number of pen are 7. Okay. When you use one pen. For the second lecture, because you need another pen. Now, you have 6 choices because if you choose for the 7 one, you will not be able to choose that for the other lecture. So, now the remaining pen are 6 in your pocket. Let's suppose now 6 pen remain. So, for the second lecture, you can choose any of the remaining 6. So, you have 6 choices. Similarly, for the third lecture, you have 5 choices. For the fourth lecture, you have 4 choices. For the fifth lecture, you have 3 choices. For the sixth lecture, you have 2 choices. But when the sixth lecture finish, now for the seventh lecture, you have no other choice. But definitely, you will only pick one. You will only pick one and that is the remaining pen. So, now there is no choice for the 7th one. Okay. But you have choices for the remaining 6th one. So, at 7th lecture, there is no freedom. Because we have no choice. We have no option. We have only one pen available. So, if we will able to use that one pen. At 7th lecture, there is no freedom. While for 1st lecture, you have 7 choices. So, for all other 6 options, you have some choices. But for the 7th, you have no choices. So, what will be the degree of freedom in this scenario? N is 7 because how many pen you have? N is equal to 7. So, N will be is equal to 7. So, N minus 1 will be, this is the degree of freedom definition. Degree of freedom definition will be 7 minus 1. So, degree of freedom will be 6. Why 6? Because we have some moment, we have some freedom for the 6 choices. But not for the 7 choices. So, this is just a simple definition of degree of freedom. I hope you understand. I am just going to discuss another example in order to further clarify the meaning of freedom of degree of freedom. Suppose you select any number whose sum is 40. Suppose you select any 4 number. Let's suppose I am just writing 4 number. Any 4 numbers whose sum is 40. Now, we can write this, let's suppose we can choose any number 12 plus 10 plus 8. What will be the fourth number? Because the total number are 4. N is equal to 4. So, N is equal to 4. What will be the number of the fourth number? So, let's suppose we want to put the A is equal to 40. A is equal to 40 minus 12 plus 10 plus 8 will be 30. So, 40 minus 30. So, A is 10. So, you will not change this number, but you can change the other number. For example, I am changing the first number 10 and I am putting this number 12. Okay. Let's suppose I am putting this number 16 and plus 4. So, 14 plus 4. So, let's suppose this is 14, this is 4. Okay. So, 14 plus 4 will be 18 and 10 plus 8 is also 18. Similarly, 12 plus 10 is 22. So, I can also put this 11 plus 11. So, it will be 22. So, we are free for these 3 numbers. But for this number, we are not free. Exactly, we will choose the 10. So, that is why we have degree of freedom for this example is, degree of freedom is n minus 1. So, n minus 1 means 4 minus 1. So, for 3 choices, we can freely move for this one, for this one, for this one. Let's suppose I am changing this number. Let's suppose this is 11 plus 11 plus 8. Plus A. Okay. So, 11 plus 11 plus 8. So, from this example, you can see that we are free at 3 places to take any different number. But at 4th place, which is this one, we are not free. We are not free to move because we have only one choice to choose that, and that is 10 in this example. So, to make the sum 40. So, you can change this number, but the 4th one, you have no option, you have no choice. So, that is why the degree of freedom is 4 minus 1. So, I hope you understand the concept of degree of freedom. Now, where we will use the degree of freedom? We can use the degree of freedom in inferential statistics. One sample t-test, as we have already discussed in my earlier lecture, we use the degree of freedom n minus 1 because we have one kind of data and we have one sample. Okay, pair t-test, we will also use this one. Independent t-test, so there are two type of data, there are two type of variables data, then we will take two sample. So for every sample we need n1 minus 1 plus n2 minus 1. So you can also write this n1 or n1 minus 1 plus n2 minus 1. So shortly we can write this n2 minus 2. So that is why we will write this n1 plus n2 minus 2. Independent t-test. Okay, because when you sum this n1 plus n2, your sample size will be combined and we can write this n minus 2. For chi-square test, we also use n minus 1. For goodness of fit, we also use n minus 1 contingency table. So, I will show you in the chi-square statistic what is contingency table, where we will, this is rho minus 1 and c minus 1, because we will check the behavior of two type of data. The one type of data will be in the rows. Okay, and one type of data will be in the column. So, that is why we just write rho minus 1 and column minus 1. And analysis of variances, degree of freedom between groups, so number of groups minus 1, normally we use this. I will also show you that how you will calculate, how you will construct in an Excel. So, automatically Excel will also pick this number of groups minus 1. Degree of freedom within groups. So, if it is within groups or between groups, it will be changed. Number of subject minus number of groups minus 1. And for correlation, we will use the degree of freedom n minus 2. So, I hope you understand. And in the coming lecture, I will discuss practically how we will calculate degree of freedom and what kind of role it play in the inferential statistic. Thank you.